I can't make this shit up. Check out the link and listen to the report on CNN. But in a nutshell, DeVos, the fundamentalist Christian lunatic secretary of End Public Education, the idiot today announced that her department is going to review the Obama-era sexual assault guidelines. And here's why. You may have thought that the problem on college campuses was the tens of thousands of women who are raped every year. You might have thought that that was the problem, and that Obama, being a decent, functional human being, tried to shut that down by giving guidelines that, instead of in the past, where everything was stacked against the accuser, he issued guidelines that required actual investigations of rape cases, or they lose their federal funding. Well, you know, he thought the problem was those tens of thousands of women who are raped every year on campus. But DeVos, of course, as a filthy, rich, fundamentalist Christian lunatic, she knows that the real problem is that occasionally a rich, white, Anglo-Saxon Protestant fraternity brother gets falsely accused. That's the real problem, those ones of cases where they were falsely accused. And maybe the two cases a year where, God forbid, they were sanctioned by their university and their rich parents had to just, you know, transfer them to another university. Well, don't worry about those poor rich boys, because DeVos has their back. You got to listen to her actual statement. It's awesome. And by the way, it explains why you don't elect a profoundly mentally disturbed lunatic demagogue to president. We didn't elect the idiot. Over 3 million by an almost 3 million vote margin, we thought we elected Hillary Clinton. And for any idiots that didn't vote, or because Bernie didn't get the nomination, and for those idiot independent voters and intelligent Republicans who voted for Trump, that's a warning of why you don't want to do that. Okay, so let's not do that anymore. Let's make sure that no Republican ever again is elected president, at least unless they're a really, you know, rational, mainstream Rockefeller Republican. You'll have to Google it, kiddies, because you won't know what that means. The old people, they know. People my age, 67, probably even people 50 know. Because they remember the bad old days when Democrats and Republicans actually worked together and passed bipartisan legislation. Those days have been gone ever since Newt Gingrich and his contract for America, and his politics are war by other means, scorched earth approach to politics and elections. So we're going to shut that down. But to do that, you have to goddamn register to vote, and you have to vote in every election. You have to vote for Democrats at every level, and then we'll get the states cleaned up. There won't be any more lunatic Republican governors. There won't be any lunatic Republican majorities in the state houses. We can fix this, people. We can fix this. And then you don't have to listen to me, recording YouTube rants. Just a thought. Andrew Paul Scatino, Why Women Are So Problematic, A Memoir in Irreverent Whimsical Polemic. That's a book I'm trying to get out before Trump gets impeached, or soon enough that thereafter, that the rage of women and their allies, you know, people like me and hopefully you, people who have, you know, sisters, daughters, granddaughters, I don't know, or even just know a woman and care about her. We can make sure this never happens again. You just Google my name, Schettino, Andrew and Paul, spelled just like you would think, just like the apostles. And I was born Roman Catholic, so you know it's a Catholic thing. Plus, my paternal grandfather's name was Andrew, and in the Scatino clan, the firstborn grandson is named after the grandfather. It's a neat tradition. My father's John. His grandfather's name was John. My grandfather Andrew. His great grandfather's name was Andrew. It's a neat practice. Anyway, 5 minutes. I hope you hung in there, kiddies. Peace out. Impeach Trump. Pence. Get them both.